final ionized iron. There was another release off the limb to the right side, but nothing at Earth, and so we're taking a look at those sunspots on the south next. Little spots are building out ahead of it to increase the overall complexity of the region. It is developing slowly, but so far, still in the manner that would eventually lead to flaring. Eyes on it, but for now, space weather is quiet. Rough forecast here for the southern part of Mexico. Not only do they recognize pressure release coming to the region, but they say the quake is less likely to be offshore, more likely to directly hit the land. Let's take a step back to yesterday's recognition that hurricane records are not so solid. Add on to that story yesterday another here suggesting that both the records and the attribution to climate change need much more data and study before stating any certainty. Now let's go back a few days earlier to that story about inconsistent polar position, the notion that the axis of Earth shifted when most of geology thought it didn't. Well, today let's add on to that the same results from Japan. But interestingly, they never even thought to suggest it was the pole shifting, instead presuming it was earthquakes twisting Japan. However, their timing matches the timing of the first paper, and both match the Arctic dino nest story from 2 days ago, which only makes sense if the poles weren't where they are now. Now that's application of previous knowledge. But time for some more. Hopefully we recall the May 5th raising of climate science, neatly broken down into sections, and hopefully we also recall how 10 professors and national lab scientists tried to come together to debunk the video, failed, and in the process revealed a number of their own failures as well. We are back to A8, the melting polar ice triggering of an ice age condition. The freshening we've been seeing is taking over and leading to that oceanic shutdown of heat transport, like the movie Day After Tomorrow, just not all crammed into a 5-day stretch. Again, freshening continues. Last but not least, another one on Betelgeuse detailing the light curves that confirm the stellar ejection hypothesis. In the unexpected category, however, the ejection outflow of material occurred over more than 3 months. That is one long, drawn-out nova-like event. We greatly appreciate your support. Tonight we'll look at data.